Hello my dear students, welcome to class 11 for the session 2021-22. I shall be dealing with the subject geography, and in today's class I will just try to detail you about the syllabus for the subject. To begin with, the subject that you will be dealing with has 33 chapters in theory section and 4 chapters for practicals. Each chapters that we will be discussing are those that we have already known to. Few, but there are also few chapters which are completely new to us. But what becomes more interesting in this session would be to know geography in a much better approach, and also to understand that how everything came into existence, because so far in geography we are only dealing with the landforms, we have been only dealing with the environment that is immediate to us. But apart from that, this session we will try to understand that how the earth actually came into existence. We will know the history of the formations of the planets. Apart from that, we will also understand that how these mountains and plains were been built, how plateaus came into existence. It is true that nothing happened in a blink of eye. It took a plenty of time for the formations of different landforms, and also for the earth to be where it is as a planet. So I hope you all will enjoy the discussions that will be made around, and then we hope to learn in a much better prospect. And I hope you will also enjoy the subject and come to know much more about the planet Earth and how we have been coping up with different situations. I once again welcome you all to the class. So let us begin with the first chapter today, that is geography as a discipline. So the first chapter, this geography as a discipline. So what it is, or what geography actually means? The word geography was first coined by Erasmus. He's a Greek philosopher, and the word also comes from the Greek word geo and graphos. Graphos or graphite. So geo, what is it? Geo or graphite is earth, and graphos or graphite is to describe earth. That means, in a very simple term, we understand geography as the description of the earth, the detailed description of the earth, how it came into existence and what it looks like from the past till today. There are various scholars who have defined geographies in their own way. It depends on to the perspective how people take it into about the earth. There are some scholars who have defined geography as the home of the mankind, as because it is the only planet that sustains life. While there are some scholars with the view that geography is the study of the interaction between man and his environment. And that is true, because not everywhere is the same type of environment that we find. There are places which are very hot, and there are no vegetations in such areas. So people living in those areas will not have a similar characteristic or a nature as to those with people living in the areas which are covered by forests, or the areas where heavy rainfall take place, or you can say the mountainous areas where heavy snowfall take place. You can even take an example of us. You, we see here that the winters, the summers are completely different And then two different identical weather conditions. We see summer season, we are with the cotton clothes, while winter, we are with warmer clothes. The houses that we construct here are different. Mountainous areas, they mostly have slopy roof, while here in the plains, or mostly in our areas, we have flat top. This is because our environment is different. So hence, there are some scholars with the idea stating that geography is the study of interaction between man and his environment. It's a relationship that we share. Well, there are others who believe that man, this earth, is a home to the man. Scholars are also of the opinion that the environment that we see and the human conditions living in that particular environment gives us the idea of what earth is. So that is why at some point the scholars they see as humanized environment. What this means is that the environment in and around us, in order to survive in that environment, we adapt the condition. At the same time, also to make comfortable living in that particular environment, we try to adapt into such conditions. So this is where we get to understand the humanized environment. But irrespective of all these discussions made by different scholars, to understand geography, there is particularly three sets of questions that we need to understand it. The three sets of questions to understand geography is what? Where? It's just like asking what happened, where it happened, and why it happened. This is a three sets of questions that help us in understanding geography. If I take an example of Himalayas and relate to the three of this set, what, where, and why, then the first question comes, what happened or what was formed? Then obviously the answer would be the Himalayas were formed. Then where was it formed? Himalayas is formed in between India and China. It's formed in the Indian Mountains. But then why it formed? So there are different theories that states why Himalayas was formed or how it came into existence. So answering these three sets of questions, where gives us an idea of what geography is all about. But then again, when we talk about geography, we don't just study geography as only a part of one subject or as a part of one approach, as because we consider geography to be a multidisciplinary approach. Geography as a multidisciplinary approach. That means it is not just one that we see in geography. There are plenty other subjects that are related to geography. But then before we discuss about this multidisciplinary, let us first come to understand that how we came to know the whereabouts and whereabouts of the people in this earth. How it started. So the question now arises, how did geography evolve with time? Or how did geography as a subject was accepted? So when we see that, historically, if we go back to the days when people lived in caves and trees, and then in this present time, we again come back to the present time, we see people, instead of living in the dens and caves, they are living in houses, They don't live in trees. They are very good dressed to wear. But in those times, people did not have clothes to wear. Then how did it evolve? It is all in the progressive of time, and with human civilization, everything started changing. It is because the change was more witnessed because we as humans started adapting the condition where we survived. We did not try going against the nature, rather we accepted what nature had to give it to us. So this is how evolution took place of not just human beings but of the entire geographical conditions or in the entire geographical space. And these are all evident from the scholars of the past and their travel books. They gave us different account of different places, understandings that what was there and what is now, where it was and why it was. For example, if we have to take an example from history, during the times of the Gupta period, Hiratsang came to India. He gave his own account about what India was all about. So that is how we came to know the ancient part of India, its economic, its politic, and its social life. And also we came to know how geographically India looked and what people used to carry out with their activities. So the time passed by. Today, what seems to be history for us, then it was the geographical condition for those people living and surviving in those particular regions. So this is where we see as a multidisciplinary approach that history and geography are linked with each other. Furthermore, in ancient times, it also gives us an idea about the astronomical science. Astronomical science where Aryabhatta, the Indian scholars, they gave us an account of the movement of the planets. Erasmus gave us the understandings of the circumference of the Earth. This is how mathematics was also included in understanding geography as a discipline. Henceforth, it would not be wrong in saying that geography is considered as the mother of all science. Just because of its multidisciplinary approach, we have consider geography to be as the mother of all science. So this is the basic concept of geography and how it evolved into science, or how it evolved as a multidisciplinary approach and why we consider it to be the mother of all science. And slowly and gradually, geography as a discipline was later included in the syllabus to be studied in the school level. Earlier, we did not have a specific geography as a subject. So thank you class for today. We will continue with furthermore discussions about how geography is understood in terms of multidisciplinary approach and how it is related and linked with other subjects. But for today, thank you all, and we all take care and stay safe.